Hello again, Raislane. It is really good to be with you back in our assemblies, and I trust that you are all well. Listen, let's carry on with our Christmas theme, thinking about those two big questions, aren't we? Who is Jesus and why did he come? And linking them together and trying to work out through some of the Christmas stories that we know and may well have heard before. How does it help us to understand who Jesus is and also why he came? Now, if your memory is good, you'll know that over the last couple of weeks, we've seen and heard what happened when the angel came to Joseph and spoke to Joseph and said to Joseph, "Give this boy the name Jesus because he will save his people from their sins." And then the angel comes at a different time, of course, to Mary and speaks with Mary and gives the same message that this baby will be a savior. He will be called Jesus. And then as we put the two stories together, we find out also that the angel said to Joseph this, "Hey, listen, this baby that's going to be born to us will also be known as Emmanuel." I wonder if you can remember what Emmanuel means. Did you get that? Emmanuel means God with us. And so we've looked at the promises that Jesus or the Bible made and God made about sending a savior and a rescuer. And then we thought a little bit about last week about Jesus, the Messiah, being God's gift to us. Well, today we're going to meet the angels again as they meet the shepherds, and we're going to find out another name that was given to this baby that was to be born in Bethlehem. Now, you might know this part of the Christmas story quite well. What we have here is it's night time, the baby's been born in Bethlehem, and on the hills in Bethlehem, there were shepherds, and the shepherds were looking after their sheep in that country and in that culture. They would have stayed out all night with the sheep. They would have slept by the sheep to protect them. They'd have lit a fire and slept by the paddock entrance, if you like, or the gateway to where the sheep were in the pen. And they would have kept the sheep. They would have guarded the sheep from any danger, from any thieves, from any wild animals. And this night seemed to be like just any other night. There they were, out on the hill, in the dark, in the cold, when all of a sudden, into the silence came an incredible light that shone so brightly. A light that was something that they'd never seen before. And in this light, was a messenger from God. God's messenger, an angel, had come to visit the shepherds. And here's what they had to say to the shepherds. Let me read it for us. It's found in part of the Bible called Luke. He's the writer, a doctor, and he wrote this account to help people understand what was happening. And this is what he says. "And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them." And in the Bible, when it talks about the glory of the Lord, it means the brightness of light, not the light of just the sun or a light bulb or daytime, something incredibly bright, something different than they'd seen before. And it says this, "And they were terrified." Remember how the angel spoke to Joseph and how the angel spoke to Mary? And some of the words that they used, well, the angel says to these shepherds exactly the same things. "Do not be afraid." You don't have to be afraid here. Something magnificent is happening, and it's all of God. It's God's doing. He's got his hands all over it, and you don't have to be afraid. And you know something, shepherds? You are going to be the first group of people outside of Mary and Joseph to go and visit this baby that has been born. And so the message continues. "Don't be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Saviour has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. And it carries on with a few other messages. But the important thing that we've got here is the message that the angel came to bring was a baby's been born. It is good news. It's for all people. And he's been born to us, for us. And his name is Messiah, or Christ. And that simply means God's chosen, anointed King. God's King has come to live and to rule and to reign, not in a big palace, not to build a big empire, but to live and rule and reign inside the hearts and lives of people. What a great message. What a great message. And accompanying this message, Luke the writer carries on and he tells us, and suddenly, out of nowhere, it was like a choir of angels. The heavens opened up and there was singing and there was praise and there was thanksgiving to God for the birth of this child. Something extraordinary was going on. And these shepherds were privileged to be in the mix of it. And then as suddenly as the light appeared and that host of angels singing appeared, they left. What were the shepherds going to do? They had a choice, really, didn't they? Simple choice. They could have stayed on the hillside and just gone, "Poor, that was mad, that wasn't it? Were we dreaming? But did that really happen?" Or, as they chose to do, they said to each other, "Let's go and see if what they've said is true." And the shepherds run down off the hills and into the town of Bethlehem, and they find Mary and Joseph, the baby, just as the angels said they would. And they fell down and they worshipped the baby and they praised God for the baby. And then they said, "Listen, let's go and tell other people about this news. This is such good news. We've got to tell other people about it." And off they went. The Messiah has been born. God's promised King has come and he's been born to us. And it's good news. And it's for all people. Well, before we finish, let me just say this. It's still good news, and it's still for all people, and God's promises hold true. No matter how old those promises are, he will always be true to his word. We've got a little word search which picks up on some of the words that we've heard in the story. So spend a minute or two on that if you wish. You'll have to maybe pause it just to have a little bit longer if you need to. And then also Dougie's back, Douglas Talks back, and he's going to come and just talk to us a little bit as we finish off our story today about the lights and the importance of the light in the dark world and the Jesus who came to be that light in this dark world. And then when Dougie's finished, I'll come back and say a prayer.
Hey guys, it's me again, Douglas. And one of my very favorite Christmas traditions that my family has is we get in the car after the sun goes down. We get in the car and we go to a really rich neighborhood where all the rich people live, and we like to go and see how they've decorated their houses. And so we're driving slowly through the snow. It's best when it's snowing. We're driving slowly through these neighborhoods, and you can see all these beautiful Christmas decorations. Everything is lit up during the night. And man, these days, a lot of people, they'll have their Christmas lights set up to music, and so they'll be playing music outside their house, and the Christmas lights are all like shining and almost like the house is dancing to the Christmas song. And it's so cool. I love seeing these light shows that people put on outside their houses. It's so beautiful and it lights up the night. It's just, it's really, really fun. But man, this year, as I was looking at these Christmas lights, I was thinking about what it must have been like to be the shepherds on the night that Jesus was born. Man, they saw the coolest light show ever. Because see, the shepherds, they were watching their sheep out at night, minding their own business, and then boom, an angel of the Lord appeared and he was super bright. And they were obviously, you know, scared out of their noggins. But he told them that they shouldn't be afraid, and he told them the good news. And the good news was for everybody, and that was that Jesus Christ was born. The promised Messiah was born in Bethlehem. And the angel told the shepherds how they could go find Jesus and that they would find the baby wrapped in cloth and lying in a manger. And after he said that, then there were tons and tons of angels all up in the sky, and they all started singing and praising God. And man, when I think about how amazing that must have looked, I just get super excited. But then when the angels left, they went and they saw something even cooler than that. They went down to Bethlehem and they went and they found baby Jesus. They found God's only son, the one who came to save us from our sins. They met him. Man, that's so cool. And they weren't super important people. These were just shepherds. They got to see Jesus, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. They got to see him when he was born. And so then the shepherds, they went out and they told everybody what they had seen. And so this Christmas season, if you go out and you see nice, cool, pretty decorated houses, and you see the fun Christmas lights, I want you to think about what it must have been like for those shepherds to see the coolest light show ever. And more importantly than that, they got to see the whole reason for the Christmas season, which is Jesus Christ. And I want you to remember that God sent his son for us to be a light in the world and to save us from our sins. And so, yeah, Christmas is great, you know, with the presents and the decorations and all the stuff like that, but I really hope that you will remember that Jesus is the reason for the season.
Hope you enjoyed that. Hope you got on well with the word search and you enjoyed listening to something more of Dougie. Let me just pray for us. If you want to join in, of course, you know what to do. You can join in with an amen at the end of the prayer. Dear Lord Jesus, thank you again for this day, for your goodness to us and for this very special time of the season, and how we can remember the birth of Jesus and all that it means, and how his names help us understand who he is and why he came. He is Jesus, he's the Saviour, he's Emmanuel, he's God with us, he's the Messiah, God's chosen King. Amen.